Since I was 9 years old, as a kid, I would wake up in the morning and look out my bedroom window and dream about raising cattle here. I'm a fifth generation rancher here in Tenino, Washington. I grew up at Colvin Ranch. My great-great-grandfather came here on the Oregon Trail in the 1850s and homesteaded here. Today, I'm ranching here with my dad and my kids, who are the sixth generation growing up at Colvin Ranch. What we're doing here at the Violet Prairie unit is we're using cattle as a tool to help manage the prairie. There are only about 3% of the native prairies that are left here in Southwest Washington, and we're seeing a really big chunk of them right here.
Prairies are an extraordinarily rare landscape. At the end of the last ice age, there was a lot of glacial material that was deposited in this area. And so it basically turned a place that gets 40 plus inches of rain. All that water hits the prairie soils and flows through that gravel and sand. What you get is a more arid landscape than you would expect. The Westside prairies were maintained for thousands of years by First Peoples. Doug fir is a tenacious species, and they want to invade the prairie. And so First Peoples would push those back with fire. Through those thousands of years of human management, many species have evolved with that fire regime. And so we have the Taylor's checkerspot butterfly, we have the streak-torn lark, we have the Mazama pocket gopher that really rely on this open prairie landscape. Introducing fire is key. It's one of the biggest tools we have in our toolbox, but it's also a challenging tool to deploy on the landscape. It requires a certain amount of capacity, it requires a certain amount of resources. Being able to utilize other tools, identifying other tools, is key to us having success in managing these rare species. Utilizing agricultural production is one of those other tools that we can use. And on Violet Prairie, we're really working closely with the Colvin Ranch in getting grazing on the landscape. Using livestock to mimic some of those fire impacts. Get those open spaces, get a heterogeneity of structure, being able to reestablish some of those native species.
Part of our family's legacy has always been about conservation. For decades, we have been implementing conservation grazing practices on our ranch. We manage the land and our animals in a way that benefits both the habitat, the wildlife that lives there, and our cattle. To have cattle grazing here again has been really meaningful. It's a way that we can help contribute to the management of this property for the benefit of the public and the community, for the benefit of the environment, and for the benefit of the wildlife that call this place home.
We would not be able to manage or restore wildlife habitat without utilizing working lands and agricultural practices. Another really exciting aspect for the Violet Prairie unit in particular is the wide breadth of the partnership to help manage an entire landscape. We've got federal partners, local partners, private partnerships, nonprofit partnerships. We're looking at this really holistically. We're not just managing our own little pieces of land. We're combining ideas, we're combining energies, and managing a whole landscape.